In President Obama's speech in Cairo this past week, he highlighted the need for mutual respect between Americans and Muslims around the world. But in the U.S., there's a rift in the longstanding relationship between one of the nation's major Muslim American organizations and a key federal agency. From member station KPCC, Alex Cohen reports.
Relationships can be hard. Sure, when you're getting along, everything is great, but when you don't see eye to eye, it can be a challenge. Sometimes you wonder if things will ever be good again. The Federal Bureau of Investigation has had relations with Muslim groups for many, many years, but it was immediately after the September 11th attacks that they realized just how important it was to have the trust of Muslim American groups. FBI Assistant Director John Miller.
Within those communities, if there are people who see something suspicious, we want them to come forward and say, I saw something of concern. I heard something of concern. There's somebody I think you need to look at.
Miller adds the FBI was able to offer its assistance, too. The Bureau investigated hate crimes and other civil rights violations, and they served as a conduit between Muslims living in the U.S. and other federal government agencies. The FBI held forums and town hall meetings with about 20 Muslim, Arab, Sikh, and Iranian groups, including the Council on American-Islamic Relations, or CARE. Hussam Ayloush, CARE's Southern California Executive Director, welcomed stronger ties with the FBI.
The benefit for us was an importance of creating a venue where the community can channel its concerns to government. Now we have a way to talk to people from inside in a friendly environment.
CARE is a nationwide nonprofit with a mission statement that includes enhancing the understanding of Islam and the protection of civil liberties. For years, Ayloush says, the FBI helped them promote those goals. These symbiotic relationships were more than just professional. FBI agents attended Muslim weddings, family pool parties. They broke fast with Muslims during Ramadan. The FBI's John Miller.
Some of those relationships transcended the official relationship between the representative of a certain group and the employee of the FBI and became true friendships.
But then relations with CARE began to falter. 6 months ago, Hussam Ayloush says, shortly before George Bush left office, his local FBI representative took him out to lunch.
We went to a local restaurant in Anaheim. It's a Persian place called Hatem. We all enjoyed the food. We enjoyed the ambiance there.
But then came the news. Ayloush was told that the FBI was ending its relationship with CARE and all of its local chapters nationwide.
We were taken by surprise at the sudden change in the attitude of the FBI. It's difficult to explain for us what happened. Was it a change in policy, especially in the last few weeks of the Bush administration?
I think there is something disingenuous about the idea of a representative of CARE saying, we don't know what this is about.
The FBI's John Miller says his agency suspended its relationship with CARE because of unanswered questions regarding its involvement with a charity called the Holy Land Foundation. In November of last year, five Holy Land leaders were convicted of supporting terrorism by funneling millions of dollars to the Palestinian militant group Hamas.
During the Holy Land Foundation trial, evidence was brought to bear that two of the founding members of CARE, who were still in those positions at the time, were related to Hamas organizers. And the question that was raised was, is CARE going to be an appropriate liaison partner for the FBI if the two founding members who are still in place are maintaining that relationship with Hamas, a designated terrorist group?
One of those founding members has since resigned. The other remains. Even so, Ayloush insists his group hasn't done anything illegal, and it has taken legal action to prove its innocence. But the Holy Land Foundation case isn't the only issue standing in the way of reconciliation between CARE and the FBI. There's also this man.
I think it's very important that I come out as an informant working for the FBI Joint Terrorism Task Force rather than be perceived as an apostate Muslim for my own safety and the safety of my family.
In February of this year, Craig Montail held a news conference at his home in the Orange County city of Irvine. He claimed he had been paid about $130,000 by the FBI to pose as a Muslim convert and monitor local mosques. The FBI has not commented on Montale's statements, but they have confirmed the use of an informant in the investigation of an Afghani man living in Orange County who's been charged with lying about his connections to Osama bin Laden's chief bodyguard. CARE's Hussam Ayloush says there was no need to send a spy into houses of worship.
We've opened these mosques. These are very open, very transparent. They've invited the FBI heads to have lectures and talks there. The community felt very betrayed by this behavior.
The FBI's John Miller is unrepentant.
The FBI has used informants for its 100 years of service. If you want to know what is going on inside a terrorist group, you're not going to get that information just by coming up and asking people, will you please tell me all the laws you're breaking or violating?
And this is where, once again, the two sides are at an impasse. Over the past few months, CARE has voiced its concerns about the FBI throughout the greater Muslim community.
There are certainly people who are out there who say, you know, you've been betrayed, we've all been betrayed, walk away.
Adina Lekovich is the communications director at the Los Angeles chapter of the Muslim Public Affairs Council, or MPAC. They, too, have worked with the FBI for many years, though, as Lekovich notes, many of their members now question whether the bureau can be trusted. But, she adds, they've decided there's too much at stake to sever their ties.
I think that in times of controversy and in times of difficulty and challenge is when we need to be talking the most. And that is really the test to me of what this relationship with the FBI is about.
Representatives of MPAC and several other Muslim groups recently met with the FBI in Washington to discuss how to move forward and repair the FBI's image among the community. The Muslim Public Affairs Council has asked for a commitment from the FBI that it won't send informants into mosques to conduct surveillance. So far, the FBI has not complied with that request. For NPR News, I'm Alex Cohen in Los Angeles.
You're listening to Weekend Edition from NPR News.